First off, a lot of prominent news is over the commercial application of drones and how they're being used in like fields like agriculture, where they're able to be used to survey the entire area, so farmers can optimally harvest their crops and apply on-spot treatment for pesticides and fertilizers to ensure that the crops are growing. And then as well for surveying, so instead of having a ground team going like unit by unit, going through a field and measuring everything out, they can have a drone fly overhead and record all of the data and then send that back to the ground.
What does SUAV stand for?
Small Unmanned Aerial Vehicles.
Drones?
Yes.
That's small.
But fancier and acronyms. And for recreational uses, like for aerial photography, which is like what I do most of the time, and for drone racing, which has some really interesting first-person videos on YouTube if you ever want to check that out. That's not what I'm going to be talking about today. So what I'm going to be talking about is how it impacts people in natural disasters. It's something that happens frequently in mudslides, tsunamis, hurricanes, and floods, are that cell towers get knocked out, and it knocks up the cell connection in that area so that people can't call first responders to call for help, and it takes away the ability for first responders to use their cell phones to be able to communicate, and it takes away the ability for people to check in with their families after something happens. And so a lot of the times they end up relying on radios and things like that, which just makes it harder for them to go through the area and carry out the missions for their own effectiveness. Another thing that happens is things in such where like a natural gas line breaks, not the gas station. But like in an earthquake where there might be a natural gas line break, and so then the area is filled with a lot of methane gas, which turns into a huge danger for explosions. It's really hard to send people into those areas because you don't want to put them at risk, and because a lot of times there's a lot of difficult terrain for them to have to cross in order to find them, which is also hard to find because it's a especially if you're kind of used to playing video games.
But there is some liability issues here.
Yes.
So the company just says, okay, you cut it out and you're okay.
So whenever you fly drones, most of the time there's a set of rules produced by the FAA in 2018 that set guidelines for, like, you can't fly over people, you can't do this, you can't do this, you can't do this, you can't do this. And you can fly for a 107 waiver is what it's called, but in order to apply for a 107 waiver, you have to be a registered FAA drone pilot, and you have to pass a basics aeronautics exam, and then you also sign a lot of paperwork that says if I break any of these rules because I'm being negligent, you can sue me for over $100,000 and throw me in jail. Yes, sir.
As always, I'm worried about the security implications of this. How hard is it to break into the signaling between the controller and the drone to take over the drone?
About as easy as cracking into a Wi-Fi router.
It has no security.
Yes.
So that really reduces the effective value, because that means that if there's a natural disaster and some bad actor notices that there are a lot of drones flying about trying to rescue people, that bad person could interfere with it. Possibly cause the disaster and then tries to make it worse.
Yeah. It's actually easier, because if you just jump the channel, most drones automatically go back home.
Aha.
So if you just start screaming on whatever radio frequency they are operating, they just
like, okay, the channel. Yeah. So depending on these, you can't, but maybe insofar as they're helpful, you can use them, but you really can't depend on them.
That could be true for most technologies, though. But they do pose a security risk that people, like companies like DJI and a couple General Dynamics have been working on five more secure ways to connect to them over distance. But for the commercial market right now, it's trivially easy to go to drones.
I was going to say, don't military has a lot of applications for drones already, right? I'm pretty sure they have some kind of encryption on those, don't they? I would assume so.
Yes. So they're typically connected through a satellite network, and they're controlled remotely using the Air Force's or Navy's satellites.
Okay.
Multi-rotors versus fixed-wing drones. It seems like multi-rotors are way more popular and they seem easier to fly. Fixed wings are much more efficient, aren't they? You can go further on a...
You can go further, but the regulations that the FAA has put out on maintaining a line of sight and keeping a distance that you have to maintain with the drone without applying for a waiver, if you do fly a drone, you are required to register it. In order to not get sued, most of the time people stick to like the multi-rotors because they tend to not go out of range for you to be able to do your maneuver. So it's a lot easier to do a quick turn with a multi-rotor than it is for a fixed wing. But if you are doing something like surveying, a lot of the times you have your FAA license, and so that's whenever fixed wing ones become more popular, is whenever range doesn't become an issue. Yes?
So, I'm sure all of us are wondering when Amazon drones are going to be delivering their pubs. And it seems to me that you said most of these have a range of 30 minutes.
Yes.
Well, that's probably, I can see why you wouldn't want a pub being flung over people. Is Amazon's claim that they're going to have autonomous drones in the near future possible?
So a lot of it depends on battery technologies getting better, but currently they are field testing it in the UK. And so for those, they typically have loads. They have a limit on the weight of the package that they can deliver, and most of the aircraft is consumed with the weight of the battery, and then their rotors transition from being a multi-rotor, so they can quickly take off and change directions to tilting forward, kind of like an Osprey helicopter, to fly like a fixed wing. So they can minimize the time that they're in the air and then return to base before the battery dies. So it is feasible if you have several ground hubs, but over prolonged distances, it becomes a little bit more of an issue.
And follow-up question, if you're delivering in the Windy City, let's say, is that going to affect duration of flight time?
Yes, as typically it has to fight against one side, whichever the wind is blowing, so the computer balances the rudder over its gyroscope. So one side kicks into overdrive, so it's just more like when you're trying to fly faster. So for areas where there's going to be like a lot of turbulence and wind, you're probably going to have to run out of your batteries on the ground stations. Yes.
How many different models of drone are currently available for recreational use?
A whole lot. There are several companies, many of which I am not capable of pronouncing with my level of skill. And many of them have producing drones over the past 7 years. Like, I believe DJI has over 20 commercially recreationally available drones.
Well,
I'm going to
ask you a really good question about channels. How many different channels of radio frequency are available to control a drone?
So the way that they communicate is by basically acting like your own little Wi-Fi router that connects directly to your phone, so you can have multiple drones in an area that don't interfere with each other.
Partially, I guess, because then it depends on how the Wi-Fi method works. So you can have lots of different devices attached to the same access point.
Yes. Typically, they try to have like a master slave dynamic where only one may be able to control the drone, but several can use the output coming from a camera or any other data that they're relaying.
Do you know any commercial?
What?
Do you know any commercial programmable UAV? So the multiple UAV can connect to the same Wi-Fi.
Is that a question or a statement?
It's a question. So if he does know any model that allows this. Because most UAVs I know have that problem. They all generate their own Wi-Fi. But if you want to buy more of them and have one centralized controller, you like the opposite. One network and all of them connect to the same. But I mean, we struggle to find something that works.
I don't know any off the top of my head. I've been removed from the scene a little bit since I came to college.
I don't know the name, but I know I have seen it done where someone used a Wi-Fi router to connect to a bunch of drones all at once.
It's possible if you build it in the drone that you buy all the controllers and stuff, but if you like to have some commercial thing that you can just.
This is the thing of someone controlling like six drones from one Wi-Fi router. So six, like just regular off the shelf drones.
Oh, okay.
So it is definitely possible. I can look up which drones they work.
Yeah, there's
a
problem